So welcome everyone for the third day of the workshop. As you can see, we moved over to Australia, so now we are all upside down. So today we have five half an hour talks, and then we will have some fantastic surprise quiz where we will work on groups on some of the most intriguing questions in linear programming and tropical geometry. But let us first start with the talks. The first speaker is Marianne Akia on tropical linear regression and mean payoff games. So Marianne, please go ahead.
Thank you. So I hope that you are hearing me well. So thank you for the invitation to talk. So I will speak about a work with Stéphane Gobert, Yankee, and Omar Saadi. Omar is finishing his thesis. And all are in the same team at INRIA Saclay. And the work is on archive also. So I will speak about regression in tropical algebra. So let me recall some notation. So here for the moment, tropical notation will be in red and the rest in dark. And I'm using Max Plus version of tropical algebra. So this is the set of real numbers with minus infinity and the addition and the maximization as an addition and the addition as a multiplication. It has several names, and on Max Plus algebra, we can define vectors, matrices, polynomials, eigenvalues, eigenvectors, etc. All these things are easy. However, because of idempotency, we have no inverses, and so negation, linear space, convexity, and dependence, rank, as you saw in the previous days, have different meanings depending of works. And things can be defined ever by thinking about the tropical algebra as the image by the valuation of the field, or just internally by using the Max Plus notations. So the problem which interested us from the beginning was the problem of approximation of a set of vectors by something, so a tropical analog of linear space with a small dimension. Why this problem is difficult in tropical algebra? It's first, we have to define what we mean by tropical analog, and then to define what we mean by dimension. There are several versions. So in this talk, the tropical analog of linear space will be a tropical submodule, which is because of positivity of vectors of elements is equivalent to tropical convex cone. So it is defined as usual algebra. So it's a set of vectors, which is stable by addition of vectors and by multiplication by a scalar. So which is and multiplication and addition are defined element wise. Given this notion, we can define what is the submodule generated by a set, which I call denote SP of V W. And now we have to know which dimension we are using. So dimension can be the cardinality of minimal generating family. This is a very weak notion, which may be very high in even in dimension n. You may have a lot of elements because it's equivalent to finding the extremal rays of a cone in the positive octant. Maximal cardinality of a tropical independent family. This is what I would call tropical dimension. But we can also use another negation, like in the work of in the talk of George Lowe yesterday, and then define a notion of Gondrominou rank, Gondrominou independent family, and so this gives another dimension. And so it's true, the sign tropical elements. And once we have this notion, we can get several way, in several way of the previous question. So we have several versions. One first question can be given set W. Can we, given set V, can we find W, which may be any set, so minimizing the distance between V and the span of W? Or we can specialize to the case where the W are subset of elements of V, subset of V. Or we can take the more general case where W is a submodule and this is now the dimension with W, which is less or equal to R. So in the first cases, the set W had to have a cardinality less or equal to R. So why we are interested in such problems? Because they arise in, things that maybe it's not linear programming, but it's related because it's deterministic optimal control problem. Also in infinite dimension, with, for instance, the Hamilton-Jacobi PD correspond to dynamic programming equation of deterministic optimal control problem. And when we want to solve these equations, there are some methods using tropical algebra developed by McKinney first, and in which you may arrive with a lot of basic functions. You have a value function. The solution will be a linear, max plus linear combination of basic functions, and we want to reduce the number of basic functions, which reduce to solve problem two or problem one. This problem, at least the second problem, is equivalent to non-metric facility location problem. It has been studied for by Stéphane, McKinney, and Sanku, and it is also related to the sparsity in max plus linear systems, which was studied by recently by Maradov. And both problems are NPRs. So question one and question two is NPR. So in this talk, because of the difficulties of solving this kind of problems, we will reduce, we will consider only the case where R is equal to N minus one and minimize the distance of V with to a tropical submodule. So with dimension N minus one, that is of co-dimension one. And we will show some application to economics. So what is the biggest submodule with co-dimension one? This is a tropical hyperplane. So tropical hyperplane is a set of vectors of R max at the power n such that this maximum is achieved at least twice. When A, the coordinates of vector A are all finite, that is, are all in R, with minus A is called the apex. And it's then the tropical hyperplane separates the space into three n sectors, which correspond to one sector correspond to choosing one coordinate which will be which you will have a maximum. Maximum is attained for this coordinate. Donc, well, considering now a set, a subset V, we want to approximate this subset V by a subset of tropical of an hyperplane, tropical hyperplane. So first we construct the matrix capital V, which is which has as columns the elements of VCAL. And by definition of tropical linear independence, the rows of V will be tropically linear dependent if and only if there exists tropical hyperplane which contains all the elements of the set, the initial set Calvi. This is just the definition. And it was shown so in several works that the rows of V are tropically linearly independent if and only if V has an n square submatrix that is tropically maximal square submatrix which is tropically non-singular. So this result shows that the tropical row rank is equivalent to the tropical permanent matricial rank, and which and then it will be also equivalent to the tropical column rank. And it was first proved by Devlin's to Stanton-Stromfels in the case where we have only finite entries, that is entries in real in reals. And also, and after proved by Isaac and Rouen, and also by us, but with us, so with Stefan and Guterman, but with a proof which use mean payoff K. And I will recall some of the results of this work because they will be extended to the problem of tropical regression. So, as a corollary of this result, we get that set V is included in a hyperplane if and only if any collection of inductors of V are tropically linear dependent. This is what I said, tropical row rank is equal to tropical column rank. So as I said, I will explain you some of the results that we used to show this result using mean payoff games, because that we use after also for the regression problem. And in particular, we considered the following operator T, which is constructed here using the matrix capital V. This operator is the Chaplet operator. It is order preserved. It's a Chaplet operator of the deterministic zero-sum game. And this deterministic zero-sum game, so at two players called min and max, the nodes of this, the states of this game are the indices I, so the indices I in 1n, so indices of vectors over vectors x. And giving so node state I, we go into a state k which correspond to the columns of V, such that even finite entries, then max choose another state which is in again in the set of rows, and the instantaneous payment is this quantity. So the fact that we choose that J is different from I is because of a property, because we want to encode the fact that the maximum is attained twice. And so given the strategy, we can define the total payment in the finite horizon L. So this is the sum of the rewards. And the value of a game is defined as the saddle point for this payment. So when we minimize over the strategy of min and maximize over the strategies of max. And to obtain that this value exists, we use the operator T, and that VL will be equal to the T iterated state L times applied to the zero value vector. So, but we are interested in mean payoff vector. Mean payoff vector is the limit in of the mean in time of the value. And Stefan already spoke about that, about the problem of mean payoff games. So we know that checking that this mean payoff vector chi is strictly negative, or that it is less or equal to zero, or that computing it, are all polynomially equivalent, and they're all in NP inter NP. And that there is also pseudo polynomial time algorithm. So we have still difficulty because it's a mean payoff game, but we know that the problem of finding, we proved that the problem of finding an hyper plane H indexed by A such that V is included in HA is equivalent to find that A is satisfies A less or equal to T of A, where the T is of the Chapeau operator that I defined before. And this property is, this result is based on nonlinear spectral, on nonlinear Peron-Frobenius theory, and in particular in the equality of several notions of spectral radius. The first spectral radius is just the supremum of all the eigenvalues of the operator T, where eigenvalue means in the additive sense. So an lambda is an eigenvalue if there exists U such that T of U is equal to lambda plus U. And so two other definitions correspond to finding the minimal super eigenvalue associated to a vector which is finite, near Rn. So this is the Collatz-Wieland number. And the maximal sub eigenvalue associated to any vector. And this is also equal to the maximum of the mean coordinates of the mean payoff vector. So now that we have this result characterizing the fact that V is included in an hyperplane by a condition on the operator T, we will find the same kind of result now for the optimization of the distance between V and HA. So we are interested now in the distance between V and HA, but for which distance? So here we will use the Hilbert projective metric, which is canonical in general in tropical geometry. So this is, it is a restriction to Rn correspond to the Hilbert seminorm, which is the max minus the mean of the coordinates. And it is a projective metric because it's equal to the norm is equal to zero on the constant vectors. So with this distance Hilbert projective metric, we can define the distance from a point to a set, and then the distance of between two sets. But here we will consider a one-sided Hausdorff distance. So that is the distance from A to B. You need the symmetry to get the true Hausdorff distance. And now we address the problem of finding the minimum A, which minimizes the distance between the offset V and an hyperplane HA. And what we get is that this minimal distance is equal to minus the respective radius of capital T, the T that I defined or that we defined already for the problem of independence and that we use again here. And it's also by there is some duality you obtain that it's also the supremum of the radius of the ball. So for again for the Hilbert metric of radius R, which is included in the span of V. So V is a set of points, maybe finite. We take the span of V to, and we need to have a ball inside this span of V. And to obtain a solution, we need to solve ever the super eigenvalue or the sub eigenvector condition, T of A greater or equal to rho of T plus A, then A will be optimal for the minimize for the regression problem. And for the with the other side, we get that minus C will be optimal for the maximal ball, the inner radius. And as a corollary, we get that tropical linear regression problem is polynomial time equivalent to the mean payoff game problem. We also obtain optimally some certificates to for the value of the regression. So for this, we can obtain we can test. If there is a niche sector, or if you have a vector A, you can test if there is a niche sector, a vector VK, which belongs to our set V. And which has the same distance as the distance from of this set V to HA. We can also use inequalities. And here is an example. So we have four points, U1, U2, U3, U4. And the span of these four vectors is in gray. The ball, the Hilbert ball centered in minus A is inside this span. And here you have, so you may move this ball, may move this ball here along this line. And you have also several hyperplanes which are optimal. We can, and one which is degenerate, which is the green one. But you have only one which satisfies the certificate. This one, the red one. So now I will show you quickly an application of this kind of problem. So application to economic to auction, so sometimes of auctions. So consider a public decision maker who chooses, which propose an invitation to tender and which take the best offer among N local firms. So there is, so a priori, if he should choose the best offer, which would be the smallest price, proposed by each firm, by the firm for each work to do. And, but there is a secret evaluation, a preference, for instance, technical quality, which is a factor Fi, which depends on the firm I, and which act as a weight in the choice of the best best offer. So a priori, it will minimize the price multiplied by the inverse of the preference. And another interpretation is that, for instance, there are some proportional bribe. If I minus one is equal to y minus alpha I b beta and b alpha I is yes, it suppose each firm I is supposed to to give back some of the alpha IPIJ to the decider, then Fi minus one act as a preference. So this is a variant of blind auctions. So we claim that at equilibrium, so if we do a lot of invitation, if the decider is doing repetitively the same kind of invitations, after some moment the firm will learn and will be able to improve their price, so for instance to raise their price if there is nobody no other firms which has the same weighted price. And so so at equilibrium we should have at the minimum is attained twice. So taking the logarithm, we add to our the previous problem of regression. And of an upper plane, and to find the secret coefficient phi fi, we would like to do a regression to find the AI. Yeah. So to infer this hidden information, we do this linear regression problem. Tropical linear regression problem, and this quantity should be some distance to equilibrium, and may be a way to analyze if there are some drives. So to solve the problem, we can use iterates like value iterations, but composed with Krasnodesky-Mann weights. And for instance, here is an example where we have three firms, six invitations with several levels, and we start with some perturbation of the perfect price, which are factors with the preferences, and do some perturbation, and so we see that firm one has two worse, firm two one, and firm three, although the firm one was the best one, has the best preference. And here it are, if this is the optimal hyperplane, and each sector corresponds to one firm. And here it's an example with 100 invitations. So I think that I have no more time. No?
Yeah, well, you can just try to wrap it up like in two more minutes.
So we also studied other version of tropical linear regression with sine patterns. So here it's the upper plane with where the maximum is prescribed to be in some set I and some set J. And we so address this kind of problem. And in this kind of problem, we can also construct a Chaplet operator, which is different now, and get also the same kind of result, so that the minimization of the distance is equal to minus the spectra radius of this Chaplet operator. And so we have also reduced to a mean payoff game. So if IIJ are part of input, so this is like the equivalent to mean payoff game. However, there is a particular case, only one, where one of the set is a singleton. And in that case, it can be reduced to a simpler problem, which was already studied a long time ago, and where we try to find some optimal matrix A among all sample points xk, yk. So it's a one-sided, sort of one-sided tropical regression, and which is polynomially solvable. But for the moment, it is the only one. And we also consider the problems with sign patterns, which may have some correlation with support vector machines, typical support vector machines, but indeed are not like that because we prescribed, we consider that the set V is divided in V1, Vn, and each V1, Vi correspond to particular part of the hyperplane, H, so the part where we are in the sector Si. So this is all, and so here it's I summarized the results. So we studied tropical linear regression problems associated to different notions of tropical hyperplanes, and we get a strong duality. So it's the same as finding the maximally bare ball, which is including the generating tropical cone. And tropical linear regression. So we, with that, we were able to solve problems where there is a hidden information in equilibrium problems of the invitation to tender markets. And so there are some other problem application of tropical geometry with to economics, which are related. And also some over regression problems with over norm distance. And here are some open problems. So here I presented the case where we approximate by a submodule of dimension exactly n minus one. What about the other case? And when r is small or when r is strictly less than n minus one. For the moment, we just studied the case R equal to 1. So rank 1, this is okay. It's easier. It's a tropical Hagen problem. And there is a lot of other problems. So thank you.